you've probably been talking about this with clients since 2022. I know our first conversation we had with like one of the largest healthcare providers in the country happened like, you know, right before Christmas. Walk me through this. Like, it's not an overnight thing. Like, this lawsuit and this court ruling is new, but this whole conversation about web trackers and the guidance and HHS and even FTC weighing in here, walk us through this journey. Like, where do we start and how do we even get here in the first place?
Yeah, so we'll take that journey, you know, back about 2 years, June of 2022. There's a technology-focused news publication called The Markup, published an investigation that it did of the top 100 hospitals in the country. They were looking for tracking technologies on the web pages of these hospitals. And what they found was that a third of them, exactly 33 out of the 100, had a tracking technology on their appointment pages of their websites. What's more is that they found snippets of tracking technologies on like patient portal types of websites, what the guidance we'll get into would refer to as authenticated web pages. You need some sort of credential to get inside. And so there was just, I mean, huge fallout after that in the industry, you know, in terms of guidances and enforcement we saw coming out of the government, as well as class action lawsuits, you know, really started to pick up, you know, against the social media companies where the information was going, as well as the healthcare providers who were giving them or sharing the information with them. So that, you know, that jumps a few months ahead to December of 2022, when OCR released its first iteration of that tracking technologies guidance. Then fast forward to July 2023. This is interesting because we'll talk about the FTC later. The FTC and OCR issued a joint letter to about 130 different healthcare organizations, essentially telling them, like, stop, you know, be wary of these tracking technologies, stop sharing your information or face the consequences. It was quite the ultimatum of a letter. And I think FTC's involvement there is really important in what we're going to see now that we have this ruling on the guidance. Then the lawsuit was filed by AHA here, along with the Texas Hospital Association and a few others, challenging OCR's enforcement of their tracking technologies guidance. As those on the webinar here might know, once that lawsuit kind of went, you know, got going, OCR actually issued a revised version of their tracking technologies. They did that even just a few days before their brief was due in that case. So interesting timing. But that added, we'll talk about later, this subjective intent to the guidance that, you know, really was a big part of Judge Pittman's opinion. And then, you know, June, like you said, that Friday, the opinion dropped, vacating not the whole guidance, but just a narrow part of it.